plan that you start our class through the Google Meet. So very few students have joined in this today's class. So we will create a WhatsApp group also. So you see and you check it in the WhatsApp group. Okay. So today's link is worked in entire class, entire 20 days, 22 days. I mean, the 32 class, whatever, again, up to June 22nd, this link will work. So suppose anybody does not get the link, the same link you can use and you can join for the class. So today you are going to discuss sociological theory and in context. So in the MSO program, there is a 26 unit. So we are going to plan the 8 classes. So we will finish the entire, MSO 2 in 8 classes. Okay. So today is the resource methodology paper. Okay. So now I request to all of you. So write your enrollment number and your name in the chat box. Okay. So whoever is written is all right. Those are not written. Kindly write your enrollment number and your name and query. You can ask in the when the sir will finish his presentation. Okay. So today's paper is the research methodology. Okay. So it's a MSO 2. Now I request to Mohanty sir. So kindly he starts his presentation. Okay. Mohanty sir.
Thank you, sir. Dear friends, I'm sorry to keep you waiting for some of the technical problems. As sir has rightly pointed you out that due to this corona pandemic, we are going to have our class in an online fashion, which is equally new to me as well. So I am also new to this kind of online classes, and hopefully and possibly both of us, all of us will learn a new kind of teaching learning a methodology, and thereby our learning will improve. As you all know, we are going to have the class on research methodology. And before going delving into research methodology paper in sociology, I would like to share you the basic thought process, the evolution of human thought over a long period of time, years together. Evolution of human thought, how human thought process has evolved, have taken a process of evolution, and over a long period of time, how from early Greek philosophy to present day, various theories have emerged, and people and philosophers like Aristotle has given shape to the evolution process of human thought. How human thought process has have taken a shape from a very primordial to the modern day. And even if we will get sufficient time, we'll also have a discussion on postmodernism as well. If you are comfortable with this kind of EA, and at times if you are not comfortable, tell me that I would also be happy to share some of the thoughts in regional language like Oriya. So if you will see the evolution of human thought since the Greek philosophy, if you will find, you must have heard the name of Aristotle, who has given importance to the faculty of reasoning. As you know, the faculty of reasoning, it has passed from the tradition of custom, tradition, and we have reached to the faculty of reasoning up till the time of Aristotle. If you will find the human reason and mind over religion, since if you will find the history of human evolution, if you will see that For around 14th century, there was the predominance of church and religion. The human thought process and the social fact around us were actually shaped as it has been devised, as it has been propounded by religion in the broader spectrum, and I would say in the Western countries, more developed countries, the church used to have a more influential influence over the theory building, thought process, and the social fact in the society. So from the beginning of human evolution, since up to 14th century, you will find that either the primordial form of religion, or in that from various form of religion, and the the institutions of religion, mostly in the form of church, have tried to save and given a save to the evolution of human thought. So mostly our religion and church based teachings have been responsible for building theories and building social facts around the humanity. And after that, we are talking about a science of society, studying the society itself from the perspective of a scientific methodology. So if we will go and understand the contribution of Auguste Comte being the father of sociology, and as you all know, sociology is mother of all social sciences, we would like to have an understanding as to how social science has developed over the years, and how the emergence of scientific methodology has contributed towards the growth and development of social science in general and sociology in particular. Here, if you will see the what has been propounded by Auguste Comte, he has devised a kind of philosophy around society or understanding society, that he equated society to social physics. He called society as social physics. Likewise, we study physics, physiology. There is the sociology is nothing but the study of social physics, and society can be understood by the use of scientific methods like our natural science or physical matter. Could you follow me? Up till now, the kind of theory propounded around or around religion or church, this kind of philosophy is way ahead of the earlier thinking, where sociology or social can be has been equated with social physics, and society can be understood by the use of scientific methods like physical methods. Auguste Comte was a departure from the earlier philosophers of his time, where he visualized that society or society can be studied in a more scientific methods. By putting more scientific method, society can be studied. And if we will subsequently go through his version of positivism, where he has given more importance to reasoning and observation. But here I will, in the initial primary slide, I would like to give you two references only to understand how society can be understood, or the society can very well be understood through his Auguste Comte's positivism. And primarily, he talks about laws of coexistence or laws of succession. Here, in general term, we are talking about social statics and social dynamics. This social statics talks about the general laws of coexistence, and social dynamics talks about the social change that happens around us in the social realm. So it is laws of succession, how society gets changed. Here, in slides, we will try to understand how understanding social statics as well as social dynamics is mostly dependent upon the role of observation as a method of inquiry of social science research. Could you follow me when we are talking about law of coexistence social statics? That is the institutions, the social institutions, various social facts that has been existing in society from time immemorial, and changes therein, social dynamics we are talking about, changes therein that has observed through observed around us. So in order to understand both these facts, in subsequent units we will go through the role of observation, how observation can play a very important role, and it can be a method of inquiry of social science research in understanding both social statics and social dynamics. In continuation of the understanding society, there is a term called empirical research. In your daily life, in your academic curricula, you must have come across such a concept called empirical research. So what is empirical research? And mostly in natural science we are talking about empirical research, but that empirical research has well been waved into social science realm, where social science talks about undertaking empirical research.
Sir, actually there is a background sound, please fix it. I am not able to hear you properly.
Sorry. Am I need to fix it from my side, na?
No, sir, not from you. It's now audible. You can continue.
Am I audible?
Yeah, yes, sure.
Wherever you are finding problem, please point it out, okay?
Sure, sir.
Yeah. If I am going very in a very smooth manner so that things are audible to you, na?
Yes, sir. Okay. Now you are audible.
Okay. So when we are talking about empirical research, before that you must understand that when August Comte was talking about reason, logic, and now we are talking about empirical research. So could you follow the pattern? Could you find the difference between logicality, rationality, and empirical research? We need to understand what is the difference between logic and empiricism. So when we are talking about logic, at times we follow the tradition of syllogism or deductive logic. You might have come across deductive and inductive logic in your BA or graduate level, where one talks about, suppose all human are mortal, Ram is a human, and hence Ram is mortal. So it follows a specific pattern of logic, and things are put in that particular order, and we reach in conclusion. In many of our understanding of social realm, social processes, and social facts, when we are talking about empirical research, we are trying to go a step ahead in understanding social realities and social changes, social institutions around us through mostly our sense organs. So when we are talking about empirical research, we perceive and experience things through our sense organs. That is the source of knowledge for us, where we say we challenge that we have undertaken an empirical research because we have perceived and experienced this knowledge through our sense organs. Could you follow me? So always empirical research is based on observed and measured phenomena. Empirical research is always based on observed and measured phenomena. So there might be theories before that, but we need to put that theory into practice. We need to put that theory in practice and find out the final outcome through observation and measured phenomena. Could you follow me? So there, social science trying to use this kind of scientificism to come out in a more scientific kind of outcome. So that is what empirical research. And what are the characteristics of empirical research? In empirical research, the first and foremost requirement is you must pose a question. There must be a specific research questions to be answered. We cannot go into understanding a social reality or social phenomena without having a particular question in mind. So there we need to have a specific research question in our mind, which needs to be answered through our empirical research. Suppose the definition of the population behavior phenomena being studied, and simultaneously the kind of processes that is being followed, description of the processes used to study this population or phenomena. When you are going to study a particular population or phenomena with having a specific research question in mind, we need to have an understanding of the description of the processes used to study this population or phenomena. Could you follow me? Here also, subsequently, when we'll go to the other units of the research methodology blocks, we'll find that what would be the selection criteria, how the things can be controlled, how the things can be tested, what are the testing instruments, how surveys can be conducted. So these things must be there as key characteristics to look for in empirical research. In any kind of empirical research, these are some of the key characteristics to look for. What are those key characteristics? Specific research questions, the definition of population, behavior, phenomena being studied, description of the processes used to study, including selection criteria, why we have selected a particular population. What are the testing instruments? The testing instruments we shall be studying in subsequent chapters. So when we are talking about Comte's positivism, so he talks about how the social Comte's first assumption was that society passes through a process of evolution. And the process of evolution is like the physical world, like the biological being. Society gradually become more complex and institutionally differentiated. When you are talking about biological being, from cellular, unicellular to multicellular development, likewise he talks about society also passes through the process of evolution, where stages of development are there from the simple to complex. A society passes through various phases from a very simple society to a very complex and multidimensional society. So what is that simple society and what is that complex society? What has been, how this journey has taken over? And this journey, if you will study the simple society, you can very well understand the simple society. We can give an example of simple society of a agricultural or pre-agricultural society to the modern day industrial society. So journey is a long one where it has not taken place in a day or two, on a year or two. The very evolution of the society itself has taken thousands of years of evolution. So the simple society has reached to this kind of multi-sectoral, institutionally diverse, differentiated, and specific, multifunctional, performing specific functions. Different institutions have developed, different new institutions have developed, specializations have developed over the years. So the first assumptions of positivism, which has been used in 19th century natural sciences, has well been put into understanding the social phenomena and social science, where the same principle is applicable, and it has been found, it has been actually true related, like the physical world, that society has always passed from a simple society to a complex society, or more diversified or more specialized society. And secondly, he also questioned that there are incremental differences in society. Interestingly, when Comte gave his philosophy of positivism, he also questioned the kind of incremental differences in societies. When we are talking about passing through a society from a simple and to a complex society, we all can understand that there is a growing differences in society. And the question was, if the simple society has passed to a complex society, or a more diversified society, how it has not disintegrated on the way? So what has kept it together that society has not disintegrated? So he told that there is a mechanism leading to social integration. And that mechanism in social integration has mutual dependence upon various institutions and organizations. So from the above two assumptions, one is that society passes through from a evolutionary process where a simple society passes through a complex society, a simple society thought process has passed through a simple thought process to a complex thought process, so has society. And the second is, even if there has been incremental differences, there has been diversity, society has not disintegrated, rather it has led to social integration because of the mutual dependence. From the above two assumptions, we can say that evolution is both a natural and demonstrable fact. Evolution is always natural, and it can be demonstrable, and it is a demonstrable fact. So he has argued that the task of society is to discover the laws of development. So the task of sociologists as well as social science is to understand and discover the laws of development. So in order to understand the laws of development of the society, what we need? We need to understand the systematic observation. We need to have systematic observation of the flow of the journey of the society. So first is to have systematic observation of the society. And how that systematic observation will be made has further been actually divided into various methodologies that we'll learn in subsequent chapters. That is systematic observation. There will be observation methods, various methods, how to observe and what kind of observation. And second is collection of data or facts. Mere observation of things will not give us an understanding of the evolution of society from phase A to phase 3 or from simple to complex. So we need to have some authentic data or social fact. And third, development of theories to explain the fact. So we need to build theories around social development. So what are those theories that our data or facts reaches into that? Based on this positivism, Comte gave his three stages of human society, how human society has passed through in the from a very primordial or a simple society to a complex society. Friends, you must understand that we are having actually 8 modules in your research methodology paper, and maybe in my teaching, I may be actually skipping it one or two concepts and ideas, because we need to incorporate 5-6 units into one class. So you need to understand, I am trying to give you a primary idea on some of the important issues or important concepts. Maybe I am unable to actually take you in the journey of the whole unit of each of the units and each of the para. So maybe you need to consult the book and units so that you can relate things from my actually teaching. Okay. So when you're talking about positivism of Comte, who tried to give three stages of human society or human development, and you can very well understand thing from his perspective that there was an age of religion, age of metaphysics, and age of reason or logic. So when we're talking that age of religion, as I was earlier talking about, things and social facts, social happenings around us in the earlier period had been mostly influenced by religion. Maybe there you will find another chapter on religion. So when we're talking about religion, it might bother you a little as to how religion has influenced human society in the past. Even religion that you are finding in it in today, today's form, was not in that kind of form in the earlier period. The evolution of religion has also taken its own time, and during that process of that journey, religion itself has been shaped time and again. So you need to understand, when I am talking about Comte's three stages of human society, the kind of age of religion he was talking about, not the kind of religion that we are witnessing today, and not the kind of religion we are professing today, or not the kind of religion that we are witnessing with its varied forms in today's world. You see, I'm giving you an example to understand how religion has shaped human society in the earlier, in its very earlier time. You'll find the details in your introductory chapter in religion, just this evolution of religion, how religion has taken evolution. There are many theories built around the origin of religion. There has been theories around how the earlier man who encountered the wrath of nature, like drought, like rain, thunderstorm, So he attributed power or supernatural power to a particular natural phenomena, and some of the sociologists, earlier sociologists, attribute that the kind of fearfulness towards a natural disaster or natural phenomena like rain, thunderstorm, all these have given an earlier shape to religion. And the earlier man tried to understand the social phenomena around him and social happening around him in through the eyes of the then religion or the then religious practice. It may be naturalism through nature or through supernatural being prevalent at that period of time. So the age of religion that has been propounded by Comte in his three stages of human society or human development per se has talked about the religion in that period. When you are talking about age of metaphysics, it's a period where human beings started metaphysics in its geographical age. If you will find what is metaphysics, you will find that when human beings started the use of pottery and all that, and where the influence of religion was there, but some of the material development had taken place, and this kind of age was called metaphysics, where human being started understanding society in the form, in a more relatively refined form, with an understanding of the matter around him. And this last stage is age of reason and logic, where human beings started understanding things from the standpoint of reason or logic. And in that particular period, when human society has started questioning things from the standpoint of reason or logic, you find that there are the period of Renaissance, French Revolution. Hello, am I audible? Am I audible, friends?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, there is a sound actually. Yeah? I'm encountering a sound.
Yes, okay? Sir, audible, but. Yes, sir, audible, but Pratap was not need to mute the mic so that it could be audible.
Oh, I need to mute to audible. Actually, I have actually muted it, okay.
Hello, Pratap. Pratap, kindly mute your mic.
Actually, I am muted, sir. Is it okay now, sir? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir, audible.
Oh.
What happened? What is the problem, sir?
No. There was a sound. There was a background sound, I thought.
So maybe some student sound is coming. Everyone should put in the mute mode.
No. No voices actually. There was a just jumping sound kind of.
What happened, sir?
Sir, okay, sir. Sir. Now we see that I was also talking about the observation, and when we are talking about observation, we are talking about, suppose in natural science, this we observe through the sense of the observer. The observer observes through the sense, right? And in social science, what is the difference between observation in natural science and social science? Where in natural science, the observer senses, the social science, observed is also added to that. So the observer is also a participant in social science. When talking about the study of society and culture, the nature of the data is different because the participant himself is part of the study, part of the society where he is studying society as well as culture. So here we can create the data that is put in natural science and the data that has been put into in social science. There is a slight difference with different concepts. And if you understand what is that concept that differentiates between nature, the observation in natural science, observation in social science, you'll find the participation of the observer itself. But the nature of the data is become the construct of social reality. The construct of social reality makes it different in the form of understanding society and culture, where the participation of the object in social science is there. And in different units, we will understand up to what is the role of how this is affected in the study of social science itself. And then we are going to understand the rules and problems of data collection. If we'll find the rules of sociological method written in 1895 by Emil Durkheim, he talks about the social fact. So before going to understand, we need to understand what is the social fact. In many of the chapters, we all will encounter the concept called social fact. Hence, we need to understand what is a social fact. Maybe it would be easy to understand that through an example, that how we can understand what is a social fact. We will have two examples to understand social fact. Suppose I would like, every day I am actually going to morning and evening walk, and suddenly a day I decided that I will go to both morning and evening walk barefoot. I will go to the morning and evening walk barefoot. And the second example, that I am going to a temple, and before entering the temple, I am putting off my shoes and entering into the temple barefoot. Can you equate the both the instances, or can you find out the differences in both the instances? In example one, I am taking a decision on to myself that I will move to my morning and evening walk today or in the evening barefoot. And the second, that I am moving into a temple, and there I am putting my shoes outside and entering into the temple. The past is that, you need to understand, the past is my personal choice and my personal taste and my personal preference. I have taken a decision to not to use shoes during morning or evening walk. It was basically my decision. But the second is, if you will agree with me, that it is not my own decision to put off my shoes outside the temple and enter into the temple. It has been a practice, it has been a custom, it has been a tradition that I must visit the temple barefoot. Could you follow what is inherent in that? Some of you might not agree with this kind of argument, and you might argue that I or we will enter into the temple having shoes. That is an exception. But the thing is that it has been well understood and well taken for granted, and society has made a rule, a tradition, a custom to visit into a temple barefoot. So this is the social fact for us. But my choice, my independent choice, or my independent taste, or my independent decision of going morning or evening walk barefoot is not a social fact. Could you follow me? Am I clear to you all? So Durkheim, in his Rules of Sociological Method, tried to give an understanding of understanding social fact. So how these kind of social facts can be studied, and to study all these kind of social facts, how there are framed rules, or there are rules being made to understand through various methods of data collection. So how do you collect data to understand these kind of social facts? And when in social science or sociology we are trying to understand these kind of social facts, here the scientific approach does not accept without proof and the role of data. Because up till now thing was different. Now when we are talking about empiricism in understanding social reality, or understanding social science from an empirical point of view and empirical research, there this kind of scientific approach will not understand or does not accept anything without having a proof of its continuation through a social fact. And all these social facts follow the systematic meaning. And that systematic meaning, we must understand that, that systematic meaning has always been bestowed by society or by culture, or cultural norms, or cultural practice, customs. So every society follows a particular system of meaning bestowed by society or culture or tradition, custom. So any kind of social fact we are talking about or we are encountered are being actually bestowed by society or culture, or the meaning or its kind of outward the understanding of that particular social fact by the society up till now has been bestowed by society and culture, and no individual going to affect that. My individual or choice, your individual or taste or choice is not going to affect that. And these choice and taste and decisions are not social facts. Where a particular social reality are being bestowed by society and culture from a very long period of time, since time immemorial, that is a social fact. And all the social facts in most of the times are bestowed, and its meaning is being articulated, bestowed by society, culture, custom, and tradition. And there comes, if you will see that, there comes the, when we're talking about subjectivity and objectivity, how things are being understood or explained in a subjective understanding of things or objective understanding of things. It can be, you can understand it in a very lucid way by the way of, suppose right and wrong. We're talking about right and wrong. When we're talking about subjectivity and objectivity, if I will give you an example, you can understand that right and wrong, from the perspective of right and wrong, at times sociologists and anthropologists, and it has been criticized in many parts of the world, when sociologists and anthropologists justify many of the customs and traditions being followed in many parts of the world. Suppose I will give you an example of the custom of human sacrifice that was prevalent in many parts of Africa, even in third world countries, in Asian countries. So there you will, how a right and wrong perspective or sociologist and anthropologist tried to justify things in the form of customs like human sacrifice. So there we need to be objective in our approach. What is right or what is wrong? It is not only applicable to social science. Even in a very recent time, even this natural science has encountered the issues of right and wrong, subjective and objective, ethical or unethical, moral and immoral. When we're talking about weapons of mass destruction in natural science also, to see how the questions of ethical and moral issues are important during data collection and during research in natural science as well, when you're talking about weapons of mass destruction and its usability, its positive and mostly negative contribution, negative impact to human society or humanity as a whole. And more recently, you will find the genetically modified or genetic engineering kind of things. So here it is part of natural science, but the research around genetic engineering also raised many eyebrows in recent times. And in the rules and problems of data collection in social science research, there are issues of managing diversities as well. So society is not like natural science, and you are not finding things as you expect in society. So there are diversities in society, and how our understanding of the society or the social fact is being shaped, and how we are being influenced as a researcher during our data collection to understand the social reality is very, very important and intrinsic to our study. You'll find in your your book the example of Savara, how a social scientist will manage the diversities during understanding of social fact. In your book, you'll find that the Savara people, they used to live with dead. Some of their kith and kin have died, and they have been cremated in a particular place. During their entire lifetime, they never think that that person has died. They used to live with them. They go to them. They talk to them. It might sound absurd to us that how can they talk, a particular community, talk to their ancestors or their dead fellows under a tree or there in a, and in daily basis they used to talk to them, they used to eat with them, and they used to explain those things when you will visit to them. So it is a social fact, and it's a social fact. You cannot go away or you cannot recluse yourself. So when you are talking about rules and problems of data collection during your study, during the study of social science or sociology, the most important and a very challenging thing is that to understand the social fact of a particular community and how, as a researcher, we are encountering that social fact. You might discount that it is not possible before a community in reality to have an intimate relationship with a dead one from your scientific perspective, but thing is that in reality they used to relate those dead friends, dead relatives, and they are leading their life in a manner that they, as if the other person is not dead, he is living with them in a daily basis. So in that sense, it's a big challenge to, it's an example, but there are diversities in societies where we will come across various kind of diversities as exist in society. We need to understand that. So how to cope with that, how to collect data, and that too with the intrinsic understanding of the objectivity of the fact. As I was talking about being ethical in our research and being very objective, we need to come out with kind of rules and challenging that the problem that has been that we can encounter during our data collection. And the another important thing is that when you are talking about social research, there are diverse nature of human being. Because we're not talking about natural or pure science, we're talking about human beings, human society, culture. So there will be, but natural, that diverse nature of human being. So it is also not easy, or it is not ethical to understand thing in a controlled or experiment or in a very controlled laboratory condition. One can understand, one can study, but it is not ethically correct to study human being or human society in a controlled or laboratory condition, in an experiment basis, like natural science. We tend to study natural science in a very controlled and very mostly in a given laboratory condition. So there, we need to be more responsible in our understanding of social fact, as well as the kind of social research we are undertaking and the kind of tools and techniques we are into during this kind of way. So for social scientists, in understanding the social fact or social phenomena around us during our research, it is very much important to apply the ethical and moral values. So there are ethical and moral constraints as well for social scientists during observation of the society. You see, apart from that, you'll find that the evolutionary theory, functional theory of, and postmodernism. You'll find the concept of postmodernism relatively new to you. And how you will understand postmodernism and what postmodernism is all about. If you'll see, postmodernism is an attitude of skepticism. What is that skepticism? Postmodernism talks and it revolves around a kind of skepticism around it. It talks about that as if there is no absolute truth. The theories which has been built around years together is always relative in nature. There is no absolute truth. If you'll find the history of postmodernism, it has developed from French painting to historical movement. So postmodernism as a concept has not applied to only social science, but it has moved from French painting to historical movement to various postmodernist thinkers, where they talked about and they actually reacted to the assumed certainty of scientific or objective efforts to explain reality. Up till now, we have tried to bent upon scientific or objective efforts to explain reality. But postmodernism is largely to a reaction to this kind of efforts to explain social reality. Postmodernist thinkers developed concepts like difference, even they developed concepts like repetition, hyperreality. So the grand narratives, the usual narratives that has been put forwarded earlier, has again been put into test, put into challenge by the postmodernist thinkers. Even you will find the postmodern philosophy questions the importance of power, power relation, and the construction of truth and worldviews. Up till now, through our social world, we have created a social worldview. There is a certain construction of truth around us that we have taken it for granted that these are the social truths, realities. Now, postmodern philosophy questions this kind of thing, where the importance of power relationship, the discourse on construction of truth and larger worldviews, they used to question all these things. And mostly in the subsequent sociologists and social scientists, even in modern scholars, it is very popular in nature. Postmodernism is very popular. Why is it popular among sociologists and among researchers? Is it popular because the kind of questions that has been raised by the postmodernism or postmodern thinkers, if you'll delve deep into those kind of thinking and their kind of questions and challenges, you'll find that they are often anti-capitalist, anti-patriarchy, anti-rational. So they are taken as a new harbinger of change, where they question the culture, values, pluralism, diversity, social justice, feelings, subjectivity. So they used to give an impression that by questioning the existing power relation, and the modern the continuing construction of truth and existing world views, they are giving a progressive, they are taking society to a new progressive place. Could you follow me? It is popular only because it tends to give an idea, give an impression that it is often anti-capitalist. We may say so that it may lead to socialism kind of thing, but it is anti-patriarchy. It is anti-rational. That means they see that postmodern culture values relativity, pluralism, diversity, social justice, feeling, subjectivity, and are often anti-capitalist. And they have tried to largely, you will see, they have largely questioned the scientific or objective efforts to explain reality. The explanation of social reality that has been the tradition of sociological thought and sociological process and understanding up till now. Now the postmodernism thinkers or the postmodern thinkers have started their understanding largely on the reaction of assumed certainty of scientific or objective efforts to explain social reality. It's a new realm of new phase of understanding society from I would say from the attitude of skepticism around the absolute truth or truth per se that has been there, existing there from earlier time. Now, can I have a discussion, please? Now, am I audible, friends? Friends, am I?
Yes, sir. Audible.
Can we have a discussion?
Yes, sir. Still.
Maybe I have not been able to actually put forth the slides, and it, in the first class it is not possible before me. I am not a tech savvy person. I'm sorry for the kind of inconvenience to you all. The next class I will try to come in more prepared in putting up the slides before you. मोर वीडियो टा भी देखा जाऊ कोन करू मोर भी किसी देखा जाऊ तैयार भी छी थैंक्स अ लिट दा इस ओम पड़ा तो देयर पूरा फिक्स दिस को दे आर मोर टेक्स इट ना friends, you can unmute and we can have a discussion. Okay
sir.
We can't see you, sir. What happened?
Oh, sorry. Am I visible to you all?
No, yes sir. You are visible. Sir, there is no PPT slide.
Yeah, yeah. May I try to give it to Panigrahi sir so that he can circulate you all. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Can you have a discussion, please?
What happened, sir? Just put him in. What happened, sir?
Sir,
what happened?
More, sir. Sorry, la, sir.
Okay. Guys, lot of time is there. Now it's, I mean, all three, all entire block is over.
My slide that has been prepared by me is complete, actually. It's a 8x8 slide.
Okay, you open for interest, but sir, I mean, what I'm telling you for next class, I mean, you cover more, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, please, Odia language also, sir. Use.
Okay, students, now whatever the sir is presented, so, I mean, you ask your whatever query you have, kindly ask. Yeah, doubt hochi pacharantu.
गोटे प्रॉब्लम जे कहिले ओडिया रे ये फ्रेंड कहिले ओडिया रे एक्चुअली कहिबारे असुविधा नै जे मेथोडोलॉजी रे पर्टिकुलर जे माने इंट्रोडक्शन टू सोशियोलॉजी रे ठीक है ओडिया रे कहबा को इजी होबो इवन आई विल फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू एक्चुअली अटर मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट इन ओडिया मो चेष्टा करिव ओडिया रे कहबा पई माने आबे ओडिया का सो देयर इज नो इशू बट इन मेथोडोलॉजी रे ओडिया रे कहबाटा टिके ओ पई मध्य व्यतिक्रम हो बट इन द सब्सिक्वेंट क्लासेस आई विल ट्राई टू से इन ओरिया ओके
यस सर यू कैन बोथ यूज इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज
हां निश्चय निश्चय आई एम आल्सो लर्निंग फ्रॉम यू आई थिंक
स्टूडेंट कौन अदि क्वेश्चन अछि पचारंतु सारंगो
सर एक्चुअली स्लाइड में रिमूव प्लीज ऐड दैट
Sir, hello.
Repeat your question.
That PPT slide is not there. Please add that.
No, PPT. PPT is see. What are the PPT slide is there, sir? You give me the WhatsApp. Hey, sir, apna WhatsApp, WhatsApp group re pakhi di ondu. Apna WhatsApp group re achandi.
हाँ, ठीक है जी मैं आज ही पढ़े दी ठीक है
पर पिलांगर वाला WhatsApp group create ही जी सही तरह अपना admin अच्छा
Sir,
apna you put it in WhatsApp group. That Igno RC Bhubaneswar MSO the group is there, na?
Sir, mu dekhilini sir, mu aji pathe debi
sir. Jadi kichi pilangara doubt achi, question achi, sara ko pacharantu. Regarding assignment, whatever doubts you have, you can ask.
सर हमें एथरे कोन जानी परबा केते फ्रेंड्स अछंती एटी केते स्टूडेंट अछंती
हां जानी परिया
हां
30 30 स्टूडेंट हैज जॉइंड टुडे
सर सर
नाउ
सर माय डियर कॉल
सर आपन देखाबे त जाउछ
मते माने ओनली दि जण देखा जाउछंती कुबेर चंद चरण मेहर आउ जने फ्रेंड अछंती चिंटू चिंटू नायक दि जण देखा जाउछंती
बाकी सब लेफ्ट आउट हे गेले
हाँ
मे बी
दे माइट हैव लेफ्ट जॉइन कर थिले सर आई एम हियर
सर वैकुंठ चंपति हाँ हाँ राइट
हेलो
या
सर कैन आई आस्क क्वेश्चन
यस
सर इन व्हाइल एक्सप्लेनिंग द सोशल फैक्ट यू हैव मेंशन वन एग्जांपल लाइक while put out your shoe outside the temple, and while walking will also use the will not use the shoe. So I couldn't relate what you were trying to explain in social fact by this through that example.
No, very good. No, actually thing is that it is an example to understand what a social fact is all about. So I gave another example. It is also there in your book. Only thing that you need to know, I took a personal decision. I was ready to take a decision. Sir, I will go barefoot or not. Okay. There.
Oh, Jada.
Hey, blank. You are
tired, people, right?
Sorry. Again, sir. It was so noisy.
This second one was, then I am the most popular. Putting off my.
I am not able to get his voice. So many people have unmuted their unmuted and it was so noisy.
मंदिर को गला बेले जोता खोल
परिक्रमा
socially accepted principle and tradition or used custom which has been devised by the society from a longer period of time, from very long period of time immemorial, this practice has been followed. It's a social fact.
Okay.
My personal choice of not going moving or the morning walk or evening walk barefoot is not a socially decided thing or socially not a norm. It's a sudden decision taken by me. All of a sudden I took it. But they are also one can challenge me that I can go inside the temple with my shoes. By putting on my shoes, I can move. That is not a socially accepted behavior also. You follow me?
Yes.
That cannot go again as a socially accepted behavior in a temple. So not to move into a temple or choose to attend. Therefore, it is a socially accepted normative behavior that has been accepted by the society for time immemorial. That's the social factor. In sociology or social science, how these kind of social facts have existed for time immemorial. What has been its functional utility to the society? Do you follow me? What has been its functional necessity to the society? Whether it is performing a function or it has a dysfunction to the society. Religion, Bartamani Ammane, religion absolute. Religion is being dividing society into many. Religion of within the miscreant. So religion.
But one thing, sir, but in that example, what is the social fact you are trying to explain?
Social fact is that the accepted norm of visiting a temple barefoot is social fact.
Okay. That norm is a social fact.
Yes. But there are, you will find thousands and thousands of social facts we are following or we are encountering in morning, evening, till night. Among the Bombay, I am a social fact to encounter politics. Perhaps there is a border, they are a border, and I'm just to go to that. It's a reflexive, it's a kind of reflex which has been rooted in our mind. Apart from that, from that, yeah, reflex kind of age. It's a thalik cone. Reflex age over 30-40 years of life. If we have great social happenings or social facts, we have to go to amar neighboring porjanta larger society bitre ame we are encountering many and the role of to understand the social patron dekhamo ame
I got it sir
नुआ नुआ रेम को जाऊ के नुआ नुआ पर्याय को जाऊ के समय अपन मेरे को अपना देखु जे तो हमरो साइबर रिलेटेड किछ डेवलपमेंट होई कि साइबर क्राइम हम देखु न्यू हाइट टू सोसाइटी इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग द साइबर क्राइम आल्सो पीपल देखुरी दे आर सोशल फैक्ट्स बिल्ड अप अराउंड अ पर्टिकुलर हैपनिंग्स इन अ गिवन पीरियड ऑफ टाइम the निर्दिष्ट period of time frame bitare gudai issues re gudai happenings re gudai social fact bitare ame dekhu je ei bhala nua jinish develop korchi ebong society ku kurbi jauchi ha
hello sir hello ha sir hello
ha suruj kon kon
सर गुटे क्वेश्चन थिला जी आपण रे ओडिया रे पढाइले भलो होनता
निश्चय निश्चय ओडिया किन कथा आछी मैडम कोन जे मेथडोलॉजी के टिकन परे परे टॉप मुडा पे हमिति यू विल आल्सो फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू एक्चुअली
यस सर
बट आई एश्योर यू दैट आई विल ट्राई टू हैव मैक्सिमम एक्चुअली ओडिया ट्राई माय लेवल बेस्ट टू हैव मोर ओडिया
ठीक अछि सर आ गोटे कथा देला सर मोर एनरोलमेंट नंबर और नामटा सेंड हो नै हेलो हेलो सर हो नै मोर एनरोलमेंट नंबर और नाटा सेंड हो नै
ठीक अछि मैडम जदि होनी त ठीक मैडम चैट बॉक्स रे अपन पठेले जदि न आछि त नै हो जदि होउची करिवे का अपन चैट बॉक्स काम करुनी ओ
नै नै होनी त फेल बतौची
नेट प्रॉब्लम दी ऑल राइट ठीक
ठीक तो किसी प्रॉब्लम है बोनी तो सर
नहीं नहीं किसी प्रॉब्लम
हां ठीक हो छे
सुन आपन करो एवरीडे क्लास हो ओके
हां
माने टू जून 22 पर क्लास हो है ना एंड ट्राई टू टेल योर स्टूडेंट आई मीन फ्रेंड्स आल्सो जो माने जानि नहंती से माने को को तो जॉइन करिवे ओके और ठीक हो छे आई विल टेल टू सर सर विल स्पीक इन ओडिया ओके यू विल मिक्स बोथ द लैंग्वेज
ठीक अछि
सर 21 स्टूडेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट तो पहिला को जे क्वेश्चन अछि पहिला पचार
हेडा सर ए खाली एनरोलमेंट नंबर आ नाटा सेंड होने तो सर कथिला बाकी बुझी होछि
ओके फाइन
ठीक अछि सर
स्टूडेंट्स यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन टू सर
सर सर हेलो
हां हां गो अहेड
सर कैन यू प्लीज एक्सप्लेन द प्रोसेस ऑफ असाइनमेंट सबमिशन
assignment see your session starts on January you have to appear examination on month of December okay so you have to submit your assignment before October okay so now the assignment question is available in the website okay you have to download the assignment okay then you have to write your assignment how you will write your assignment assignment should be write on the A4 size paper okay so you have to give left margin and right margin so A4 size re one left margin mane kichi margin chadibo left re right re bhi kichi margin chadibo hala so left margin kon pai na apan gar numbering korebe 1 2 3 4 5 question number right margin is blank you will not give any you cannot write anything in the right margin so you have to write your answer within the space what is the left row with the middle part left re kichi likhibo ki right re kichi likhibo first to write your question then start your write your answer introduction body conclusion and assignment sabole gote side lekhibo back side kichi lekhibo ni blank chadibo okay right margin ta kahi chadibo jetlo assignment ta evaluation karibe counselor ce right margin re comment debo to assignment finisher kala pore se assignment evaluation kala pore taku back karike nei ja and front re jo cover page thibo seithire तमरा एनरोलमेंट नंबर तमरा ना तमरा प्रोग्राम तमरा कोर्स कोड स्टडी सेंटर कोड एति की लेखी तम स्टडी सेंटर रे सबमिट करियो ओके
sir.
Go ahead.
Sir, we cannot submit our assignment in online process.
Yeah, you can submit it online.
Okay, both online and offline.
Now your time is there. You have to submit on month of October. Okay.
Okay.
So you can, if you want to submit that time, if the pandemic will continue, because now students are submitting online. If that can continue, you can submit in online also.
Okay.
Sir, online in PDF form?
PDF.
So how can we get our materials?
What?
So what about the materials?
Materials, see, you had already given you the soft copy picture?
Yes, sir.
So now, once the pandemic will over, the material will come to your house.
By post,
yes.
Okay.
So as long as you are not received your by post, so kindly manage with your soft copy. Because I had given in the mail also, I had given you in the WhatsApp group also. Okay. You are putting the Telegram also. So you download and you use it.
Vinay, are you able to actually hear me, Vinay? Actually, you need to unmute your voice. You need to unmute to have a question. Vinay.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you please explain about metaphysics stage?
Well, we're talking about metaphysics stage. Actually, it's a advanced age from your, when we're talking about stage of religion to a metaphysics where with the understanding of the nature around human being, they have an additional understanding of matter around them, and they have started using the matter and the relative understanding of matter around them and religion taken together in the stage of metaphysics. Okay,
sir.
Any student has joined for the Koraput region? Dear learner, yes, anybody from Koraput?
Yes, sir.
From Koraput? Hello? What's your name?
Vikas Kumar Behra, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, go ahead. If any question, then you ask. How do you feel the class? Class ta kemiti laguchi?
It's good, sir.
Online class is a new kind of, let's say, because of the pandemic. So it's a new kind of, what I can tell you, experience. Okay, because you also never knows about all these things. So I mean, I request to Pratap sir, from the next class, because now you have to take the class for 140 minutes.
Yeah, sir.
So you prepare your slide down that way, and you have to ready for your content. Okay, if students are demanding, use Odia. I mean, the terminology, use English. Okay, sir.
Sure, sir.
If they want, you can speak Odia. Not an issue.
Sir.
They interested to listen in Odia. Use both the language, multi-language, but sir, content, what I feel today, content is very less.
Yeah.
Because you have to present your content around 140 minutes minimum.
Content was less actually today. Yeah.
So next class you have to prepare on that way. Sir. So students, go ahead. If any doubts, then you go ahead. And I request to all the students, before coming to the class, because at least you should read in the soft copy. Yeah. Because we provide you the soft copy. Before coming to the class, come with a prepared way. Otherwise, no, you know, the class is no meaning for you. Because if you know, because it is not possible to complete entire block in one class. Because sir cannot touch entire things. Sir only can touch the important thing. So if you can come with a prepared way, so you can clarify your doubts and you can put more questions to sir. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So then you, any question is there? Jodi kichi question ache pachara
sir, can you explain the difference between natural science and social science?
Yeah, the gotte jin sam odia kauche. I'm trying to elaborate things in odia. I mean to the natural or pure science katha kauche, but a bag way re jodi ame bujhuche je ame gotte perfect laboratory condition re gotte controlled environment re gotte metal ya pe chesta karuche. ठीक है जी मन कर ना हमें पूरा एकदम ये को एलिमेंटरी यदि वर्ल्ड को साइंटिफिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ये को देखिबा तला हमें कहचे टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ हाइड्रोजन प्लस वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इन ए परफेक्ट लेबोरेटरी कंडीशन विल प्रोवाइड अ ब्रिंग इन वाटर. ओके वी ऑल एग्री विद दिस काइंड ऑफ टेंडर बट व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अंडरस्टैंडिंग सोसाइटी और कल्चर or social behavior, social relationship, or for that matter, any social happenings around us or social fact, do you agree with me that you can have a controlled laboratory condition whereby I or you can understand some social relationships or some social fact happening around us? Is it possible? Amo pakhere emiti kichi अच्छी मेकानिज्म जो द्वारा हमें गोटे सोशल प्रोसेस को सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशन को सपोज मैरिज फैमिली दीज आर सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशन इज कॉल्ड सामाजिक अनुष्ठान कैन वी अंडरस्टैंड मैरिज फैमिली एक सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशन H2O विल ब्रिंग वाटर हमें तो कोई परिवार जे दिस काइंड ऑफ बिहेवियर विल ब्रिंग इन दिस है परिवो कौनसी प्रकार पर्टिकुलर माने बिहेवियर विल लीड टू दिस काइंड ऑफ रिजल्ट कैन यू से कैन यू लीड टू दिस काइंड ऑफ कंक्लूजन इन सोशल साइंस इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल वर्चुअली नॉट पॉसिबल हमें यदि आहुरी बड़ को जाई के देखिबा माने बेले-बेले कथाबार्ता हो के से छोटा सपोज गोटे वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड हैज बिकम अ मर्डर हैज बिकम हैज कमिटेड अ क्राइम आमे बेले बेले कथा हो ता पूर्व घंटाटे पूर्व मो पाखे थिला आउ आई एम अनेबल टू कॉम्प्रिहेंड दैट माय फ्रेंड हैज कमिटेड दिस काइंड ऑफ क्राइम कि नहीं बेले बेले कुडी फॉलो मी आउ बेले बेले आश्चर्य हो जे मो सांग जे मो घंटाटे पूर्व मो पाखे थिला जहाँ को मु बहुत जानी छी बोलकरी ही इज नॉट सच काइंड ऑफ पर्सन एंड यू आर हियरिंग दैट ही हैज कमिटेड अ ग्रीवियस क्राइम. That is only because human behavior, human relationship is not predictive at all. You cannot predict human behavior, human relationship, human institutions, the way it will move and the kind of dynamism it has. So there were society ko bujhiba pai social science, society, culture, institutions, organizations, social relationship, eguda ko gote ट्राइड एंड टेस्टेड लैबोरेटरी कंडीशन भितर रखिकरी आमे गोटे निर्दिष्ट निर्जासरे उपनीत होबा एगुडा को भारी डिफिकल्ट ऑलमोस्ट नेक्स्ट टू इम्पॉसिबल तेणुकरी देर इज फार डिफरेंस इन बिटवीन सोशल साइंस एंड नेचुरल साइंस वेयर नेचुरल साइंस रे गोटे पर्टिकुलर थ्योरी विल ब्रिंग इन ए पर्टिकुलर रिजल्ट इट्स ए ट्राइड एंड टेस्टेड मेथड. But in social science, although we are talking about empiricism and putting all our scientific methodology into practice during data collection and during social understanding of social behavior or social relationship, still it has got its own limitations. Could you follow me? Am I clear to you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
कारण आम सब सोशल साइंस भितर ऑब्जेक्टिविटी इन सोशल साइंस रिसर्च क्या कौ एथिकल एंड मोरल वैल्यूज क्या कौचे कारण आप नेचुरल साइंस रे ऑलमोस्ट से गुड़ाक पाइबे ना
आउ कारो किछि क्वेश्चन. अरे सर हैज टेकन सो मच ऑफ आई मीन थिंग्स टू यू आपने किछि यदि बुझी ना पचार डोंट बी अफ्रेड टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन. ओके Pacharaji, which is very frank and very, open to this. Otherwise, you cannot clarify your doubt. Okay, there is a time, another 15 minutes there. Go ahead, if you want any question, if you want to have any query, regarding IGNO, exam, whatever things you want to ask, feel free to ask.
Hello?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, go ahead.
Hello, sir. आपण ठीक क्या करू जो subjectivity आउ objectivity रो example दी थले right आउ wrong आउ किसी example दे पारी बे?
नहीं वो जो example दो थले मैं actually right and wrong का example हाँ मैं बुझली कथा हो ची I'm a subjective understanding of society and objective understanding of society.
अच्छा सही ना मुड़ी बुझी पाल लेने.
हाँ मिस्टर आमे जितेबेले नेचुरल साइंस को बात देकर सोसाइटी को बुझिबा को जाउ छे आमो पखरे बडो चैलेंज कोन नेचर रे तो नेचुरल साइंस रे तो आमे जानि छे देयर इज लेजर चैलेंज देन सोशल अंडरस्टैंडिंग सोशल सोशल साइंस ए सोसाइटी काहेकि ना एठी आमे निजे इन्वॉल्व दिस रिसर्चर इज आल्सो ए ह्यूमन बीइंग लिविंग इन दैट सोसाइटी एम्ब्रेसिंग दैट काइंड ऑफ कल्चर एट टाइम्स बुझि पाले ना मु जो सोसाइटी भितरे रहू छी से सोसाइटी रो गुटे निर्दिष्ट विषय वस्तु निर्दिष्ट अंग निर्दिष्ट व्यवस्था निर्दिष्ट सोशल प्रोसेस को मु अध्ययन करबा पई चेष्टा करू छी एवं एट टाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस बीइंग ए पार्ट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर कल्चर इट मे सो हैपन दैट माय ओन सेंस ऑफ जजमेंट माय ओन काइंड ऑफ जजमेंट हैज इट्स रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन माय स्टडी Whether I am doing it deliberately or not, but it has been tested time and again that at times trying to be very objective has also led to subjectivity have impacted the entire actually study. जणे जतबे बहुत जोर रे चेष्टा करिकरी मध्ये अनेक स्टडी रे देखा जाय छी जे निजर जो कहा जाय सेंस ऑफ जजमेंट निजर जजमेंटली आमे हे जाऊ से गुडा कर इफेक्ट पड़े तकर ऑब्जेक्टिविटी सोशल साइंस रे सेटा खाली गोटे नो बहुत जगह रे एटा गोटे ता पर मोर थिंकिंग एबिलिटी मोर परसेप्शन माय काइंड ऑफ माय नोशन ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर सोशल रियलिटी हैज इट्स बियरिंग अपॉन माय स्टडी कुड यू फॉलो मी My perception on a particular issue. Suppose I am studying a particular an aspect of a particular religion, which I am also following. It may so happen. I am not saying that it happens always, but it may so happen that my notion, my own perception, might influence my study. So it is a bigger challenge in social science rather than in natural science to put a researcher aloof from the study he or she conducts. It is very easy to say that I am keeping myself away from the kind of study I am undertaking, but virtually at times it is impossible before a researcher to undertake a purely objective kind of study. Would you follow me?
Yes, sir.
And when we are talking about right and wrong, ethical and moral, at times our ethical and moral judgments do impact our study. We are studying a particular society as it is. We are trying to study the society as it is. We are not there to put our own notion, our own judgment, our own kind of perception, and what I like or dislike about a particular society I am studying. So it is very, very, very important for social scientists in general to keep control over these kind of issues. Wrong, right or wrong, moral or immoral, ethical or unethical, these kind of issues will always crop up in your mind when you are dealing with subjects very sensitive to you. To you or your society or to things nearer to you or nearer to your own vision, mission, ideas. Would you follow it?
Yes, sir. Sir, I would have a problem here. I ignore WhatsApp group.
ନାଇଁ ସାର୍ ତ ଶୁଣୁଛନ୍ତି
ଯଦି ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ସଆପ୍ ଗ୍ରୁପରେ ଆଡ୍ ହେଇନ ତମେ ମତେ ତମେ ମୋର ମୋ ନମ୍ବର ଅଛି ମୋ ନମ୍ବର ରେ ମୋର ହଉଛି 9861154807 ओके
सर
यू सेंड मी योर व्हाट्सएप नंबर सो देन आई विल ऐड यू
सर एक्सक्यूज मी सर आउट थरे कोई परबे
98611 हां
सर
54807
807 थैंक यू सर और सर मोर से स्टडी मटेरियल गुडा किछ आसी नि मु केमती कर
स्टडी मटेरियल पार्ट इज अ कॉमन प्रॉब्लम बिकॉज़ ऑफ ड्यू टू दिस पेंडेमिक I have already given the answer is same to you also. Hey, pandemic pai bahi milini. Ame apanaku soft copy deichu mail re. Thik achi? Kimba WhatsApp group re add kale mu WhatsApp group re bi soft copy deichi. Apan se soft copy ko download kare padhantu. Jadi apanakar mail ID amo pakare correct achi, tale ame mail ID re bi apanaku pathichu.
Ha
sir. Ekli jo pando hard copy pai na handi, kindly manage and bear with us to read soft copy.
Yes sir. Thank you sir.
Okay, fine. Anybody? Aau kar kichi question achi? And I request to all of you, if you know anybody for a friend who might be has not received any message or mail or WhatsApp group or whatever things, tell them. Every day 10 to 12 o'clock we have a class for you. Okay, I have already told you MSO2, your research methodology paper, it will continue up to 29. Okay, we are providing 8 class, then your MSO1, okay, it will start. Okay, that will continue your 30th to June 6th. Then your Indian Society, that is June 7th to 14th. Okay, then your June 15 to 22nd, okay, so that social development paper, it will start on 15th of June. So up to 22nd your class will goes on every day 10 to 12. So see, you are putting lot of effort. Now your ideal, no work, you are sitting in the home. It's requested to all of you, kindly join for the class. Otherwise no meaning to have a conduct this kind of class. Okay, so it's request to all of you, it's my dear learners, you are very mature learners, because I know I am not imposing you. Either you are not interested for the class. If the class is interested or not, tell me. Class is interesting or chhina nahi?
Yes sir, it is.
Are you enjoying or not?
Interested sir.
Nah, sir is not effective.
No sir.
Be open yeah. So if it is effective, so my dear learners, next class always prepare to kindly read. Okay, might be sir, next class block 2 we are going to discuss, am I right?
Okay
Pratap sir, Pratap sir, Mohanty sir, okay, so what I'm telling you, so next class sir is going to discuss about the block 2. Okay, so what I'm telling you, before coming to the class, please learners, go through it. Okay, at least padhondu tike. Nowadays everybody is a laptop, everybody is a computer, everybody is a Android handset. So now you have no work. You are sitting in the home. Now you are not going anywhere. But you are working or whatever. Maybe you are free now comparatively. So it's a better for you. Kindly go through it. Okay. So then it will be better for you. Because if you come with blank mind, what sir will going to tell you? Because post-session degree, the post-session course, the post-session material is rich material. So if you will not go through with the material, ଭାବୁନି ଏଇଟା ଆପଣ ମାନଙ୍କୁ ଏତେଟା ଇଫେକ୍ଟିଭ ହବ ମାଇ ରାଇଟ୍ ସତନା ମିଛ ଯଦି କିଛି ଆମେ ପଢିକି ଆସିବା ମୁଁ କହୁନି ଆପଣ ପଢିଲେ ସବୁ ବୁଝିଯିବେ ଯେତିକି ବି ବୁଝିଲେ ଆପଣ ସବୁ ପଢିଲେ ସିନା ଡାଉଟ ଆସିବ ପଢିଲେ ସିନା ଆପଣ ସାର୍ଙ୍କୁ କ୍ୱେଶ୍ଚିନ୍ ପଚାରିବେ ନାଇଁ ମୁଁ ଅଛି କ୍ଲାସରେ ଅଛି ତ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ଆପଣ ଆପଣ ଆଉଟ୍ ହେଇଗଲି ନାଇଁ 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 ଚାଲିଛି ତ ସାର୍ So, my learners, what I'm telling you, I'm audible to you?
Yes.
So, what I'm telling you, take kindly padhi ke aso. Okay? So, so that tamo paim bhi bhala hava, sara paim bhi bhala hava. And tamo ko bhi class te interesting lagi ho, nahi? Because see, igno is not a, it's a very big inability. That's why it's called a people inability. So, you are a student of igno. Don't feel that the distance education students are not at par with the conventional system. See, now, due to this pandemic, everybody is coming to this board. Now, everybody will be coming to the online classes only. Because nowadays, I don't feel this pandemic will continue, this corona will continue for the longer period. So, it's not possible to sit in one classroom. Or it's not possible to interact face-to-face in the classroom mode. So this is the virtual classroom will give you all kind of knowledge. The knowledge sharing, learning, everything will possible in now only. Because this online platform is giving lot of opportunity and immense scope. Amaku bahut scope douchi to interact each other. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
What I'm telling you. So learners, so be prepared. ସମସ୍ତେ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ସଆପ୍ ମାନେ ସମସ୍ତେ ମେଟେରିଆଲ ପାଇଛ ତ ଆଇ ମିନ୍ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ମେଟେରିଆଲ ଆଇ ଏମ୍ ନଟ୍ ଏବଲ ଅଫ୍ଲାଇନ୍ ମେଟେରିଆଲ କିଏ ପାଇଛ ବୁକ୍ସ ନୋ ଓକେ ଫାଇନ୍ ସୋ ବିକଜ ଅଫ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଓନ୍ଲି ଆଇ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡ୍ ୟୁ ଦ ଅଲ୍ ଦ ଫୋର୍ ବ୍ଲକ୍ସ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ୱାନ୍ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ଟୁ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ଥ୍ରୀ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ଫୋର୍ ଓକେ ସୋ ନାଓ ଏମ୍ଏସ୍ଓ ଟୁ ୟୋର ଏମ୍ଏସ୍ଓ ଟୁ ଇଜ୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଅନ୍ ସୋ କାଇଣ୍ଡଲି ଗୋ ଥ୍ରୁ ବିଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଏଭ୍ରି ଡେ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଡିସ୍କସିଂ ୱାନ୍ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏଇଟ୍ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଏମ୍ଏସ୍ଓ ଟୁ Okay, in each and every block there may be a 3-4 units. Okay, so every day you are going to discover the 3-4 units. So kindly go through with it because research methodology is a very nice kind of, I mean, topic. So because it's a empirical data, quantitative, qualitative. Okay, so these are things and how to write a, I mean, your hypothesis, your synopsis. All these things will come. I mean, how to collect a data, sampling. So all these things will come. All these things, sir, will, I mean, metaphoric. All these things will come in this research methodology. And it's a very nice kind of subject. Okay. And sociology is an emerging subject. Okay. So rightly you're choosing the subject, might be definitely you all have interest in this. So dear learner, it's my request to all of you. Don't come with blank mind. Okay. Come with some prepared way. So it will be useful and it will be really helpful to all of us. Okay. So, anybody have no question now? Would I wind up the session or have anybody has any question? So, with this notes, I am winding up the session. Okay. And we are hoping more and more number will join in the next class. So, tomorrow is your 10 o'clock in the next class. So, again, you will join on the next class. Okay. So hope, I mean, stay safe and stay home. It's a slogan of our government. So stay safe and stay home. So, I mean, with this note, I'm ending the class, okay?
Sir, thank one you question. Very much.
You will join in tomorrow.
Sir, one question. Could you get the recording of this class?
Yeah, I will put in the WhatsApp group, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You will check in the WhatsApp group and also you have YouTube channel.
Telegram
also will put it, okay? And also you have a website on the YouTube. You will go to the website. There also will put it. But today itself, I will put in the WhatsApp group and Telegram group, okay?
Fine.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Wait.
more options, but then.